Release VX2.8 continues to make a designer more productive with new technology. In this video, we will highlight the ability to create intelligent net shorts, conductive shape DRC control, and plane shape priorities. To start, we'll look at intelligent net shorting. Why would you want a net short? Well, typically, if you have an analog circuit and a digital circuit, you have an analog ground versus a digital ground. At some point, you need to combine those together, and that's where net shorting comes into play. Most tools play around with workarounds to get this done. To start out, we'll move over to the schematic. Over in the schematic, you simply create a two-pin symbol. Nothing special about it. It's just the two-pin part, and you can put your two nets on either side. In this case here, I have a two-pin symbol that I've just assigned an 0402 footprint to, but you can assign, obviously, any size footprint you like. Go over to the layout. Here is that part that we created with my analog ground on one side and my digital ground on the other side. To use this function, we simply start routing. We hit T on our keyboard, and that turns on the tiebar function, and then you can see we can click the starting point and the ending point, and it will automatically put a short across that net for, or across that component for us. We can move it if we didn't like the placement of it to a different position if we choose. This will prevent any DRC violations, and yet we can still continue to route as normal off either side of that component. Next, we'll move over to conductive shape DRC control. What this allows you to do now, instead of having one set of DRCs for a given shape, you have the capability of choosing DRC that is going to be used. So by selecting our conductive shape, which I've created here as a low inductance path between these components, I, in my properties dialog box for this conductive shape now, we have DRC type. And in there, you'll notice a list of trace, via pad, through hole pin, SMD pad, and plane. If we open up our constraint editor, you'll see that we can obviously have different design rules between each one of any of these items. So trace to trace, trace to pad, via plane, SMD, through hole pin. So this gives you a little bit more control over which DRC function this plane shape is having to comply with. Lastly, let's take a look at plane shape priorities. This was an enhancement to make it easier for users to create plane areas and not worry about the order in which they apply them. So previously, the order had to be adhered to in order to make sure the inner planes would have keepouts around them compared to the outer planes. Now, it's much more intelligent in how this works. All right, so we'll go ahead and create a plane shape here. Notice when this plane shape is drawn and it overlaps into this one has a higher priority since it was drawn last compared to this plane shape. However, if I take and draw a bigger one over the top of that, the one that is inside of it now has a higher priority versus the one on the top, ensuring that we have a clearance around it. So the tool is more intelligently selecting which plane shape should appropriately be inside of the next one instead of it just being based off when each one of those shapes is drawn as the priority. So this is an intelligent enhancement where the tool is making the proper choice based on the plane area shapes that are being drawn and which one more than likely is the one that you want to have the highest priority.